and then from these 200 only made, and this car, this special one, is a car which was at FIA in Paris for homologation. So, and only 34 of these cars left, two are here, the original car for FIA, and the white one over there, which is the, the three times Scandinavian championship winner. You know, we were with this car with in Tagus Gris.
Yeah. And you told me then that this is a special one.
And this one is a artwork. The car was in silver originally. And this car was a French hill climb champion 30 years ago.
Really, this one, not the motor. This one.
In this group, for this group. And I said to a friend of mine, which is a famous artist in Munich, make a nice art design with spray can, 400 hours. Spray time,
yeah,
400 hours. Three layers.
Made manually.
Manually 400 hours work, and the car is out of the 60s. This was the period of Brigitte Bardot. You see the face of Brigitte, the lips of Brigitte Bardot. And I bought a sexy puppet, and we will put the overall and helmet, and we have
her on the steering wheel.
We have long hair, cigar. We have nice shoes. We have to dress her. I only have collected everything together. And also the helmet is done in the same, basically art design. Mm-hmm. And we will sit her in there, keeping the wheel. This is also a Renault Dauphine Group 5. This could be one car to drive these illegal type cars, or not Fiat type cars. This car has a 1600C Alpine engine.
So next year I am waiting for you. 150 horsepower
and very light, yeah. Plastic screens and no weight inside, whatever. This
you should go with this one.
And very noisy. This is really but not road legal.
Yeah, but in the center of the city you have to be road legal when it's the close the all the center.
The first car after World War II from Renault was the Ford CV, which was used in track racing as well as in hill climb racing as well as for rally. They had three different engine modifications, and this one has a 1000 cc engine with about 65-68 horsepower, quite fast, and short gears, runs only 120 kilometers an hour
in
the 50s. And this car is a Renault R8S, this yellow one, Renault R8S. And this car, you can see the black and white picture, big black and white picture. This was this car on the right hand side. This was this car in 1970 in the French Sea Alps. And I found this car back in Spain. I sold it in 72. And it's my original car. Yeah. There is two, three cars which I tracked and found back come here.
I like it very much because it's the car based on our Dacia 1100.
Yeah. More of these over there, different models. So the Formula Junior from 1959. You already know we have been in Cluj-Napoca with it. And this car is a famous car from Michael May. Michael May won the Monte Carlo Formula Grand Prix in 1959 with this car.
You felt it well on the, let's say, the racetrack we had in Cluj, because it wasn't a racetrack.
Yeah, this would have been more fun in Tagus Gris. For it was too narrow. mm-hmm. And you only do first gear and second gear, and this
the,
is.
And I think the steering wheel is way bigger than it is on the race car. Right?
Yeah, in small. Yeah, but this is the original wheel.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't change things. You know, cars. This, all these cars in here are FIA legal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but comparing the cars in which you, if the racetrack is narrow, you cannot.
Yeah,
now
we see. You always hit your fingers. Blood is coming. I always have a problem, even at larger racetracks, if you really have to.
That's why I'm saying that it's better a smaller steering wheel on a car on a racetrack.
So this is also a French Fournier Marcadier, a kit car. The technology is the same engine, gearbox, and axles and whatever as the Renault Dauphine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, with a 1000cc engine. And the color, this is just to have fun with the girls. So this is mm-hmm. at Rosfeld Rennen Hill Climb Race. My daughter at the steering wheel and my and Horst Junior's wife at the co-pilot seat. This is Renault R4. I was driving Renault R4 in 70, 71. I had three cars at that time, or four cars at that time. And with this, with one R4, I was driving Polish Rally. In best result was at Polish Rally in Belgium. We finished third with this type of car.
Back in
1970. I can show you the pictures.
We will
there is
that.
Picture.
Yeah, yeah.
And this car was winner of the French R4, Renault R4 trophy in 2009. So 10 years ago, this car, original car, won.
Yeah.
This is an old chassis of French Samson. This is also Renault Matra Jet, very rear car, very good car. This car won a Dutch Rally Championship, track championship. And the technology behind it is Renault Gordini. Also, also Renault R8 engine, gearbox, and parts of the axle. This is Abarth Scorpione, the yellow one. Italian Lombardi Abarth by Carrozziere Lombardi, a very nice design. Basically, the chassis is Fiat 850, and Abarth made different engines. You will see the other one, the green one, which has a 1600cc Abarth engine, which is very strong and powerful. So this is a very rare thing, only one left in the world, with a nine-cylinder aircraft engine, but the engine has broken. In a race in Switzerland, Klausen race, I broke the engine going downhill, very slow speed, and engine exploded. And since 2 years, I have it in a workshop for repair, but not yet finished.
Mm-hmm. It takes a lot of work.
Yeah, and this is a copy of an original Renault Alpine Renault Gordini service car for towing and.
Yeah, but also Dacia made sort of this thing.
Yeah, I know. In license.
It was called the same.
Yeah. So, and this is my first Renault Alpine from 1974. Original paint, no modification. The car is as it was. Original paint, everything only this white and the rims. The painting is new, but everything else is as it was as I bought it in 1974. And the price of it from the Renault Sports department in 74 was 14,000 Deutschmarks, so 7,000 euro. Today, for a car, original, only one owner, original color, whatever, a car like this is not less than 95,000 euro.
Yeah.
So this, you know already?
Yeah.
This is my favorite car, Renault 1600 S, Group 4, very strong and very strong. This one is my favorite. And the yellow one is the same, also Group 4, original work specification as this one, but engine is lower power.
Then
the blue, yeah. This has approximately 20 horsepower less. Mm-hmm. So this is original FIA legal R12 Gordini, original specification. This is real, absolute original, nothing modified, so whatever the also engine, everything.
Can you open, please, the... If you are a woman in Romania with one of these, all the people are saying, oh, it's an old Dutch.
You see, nothing modified, is it as it was from the factory at that time?
Yes. Really nice.
If you see what I have seen in Târgu Secuiesc as well as in Cluj, Napoca, all these R12 around, all modified. Nothing original, nothing, not even one original one.
Yeah, but until the 72 they were made with French parts.
Yeah, I know.
Before,
I know the
and after.
I know well the history of all Renault license manufacturing in Romania, in Bulgaria, in Mexico, and all the others.
I think the...
Yeah, you took a picture of this?
Yes.
This is the old. The old history, summarizing for people ask what have you driven. You see Skoda in 1970 at Olympia Rally, Works, Steyr-Puch, Fiat, Simca in Finland, Simson, Simca in Switzerland, Opel Kadett in France, wherever, Renault Gordini in France. This was the former boss of Renault Sport. At Rally Lyon-Chavonnière, Rolf Schmidt is his name, Rolf Schmidt, and this was at Rally Lyon-Chavonnière, and different other ones.